The cabinet says it will spend nearly 10 billion NT to boost the country's birth rate. Starting July 1st, a raft of benefits will be made available, including increasing the state subsidy for unpaid parental leave from 60% to 80% of the monthly wage, as well as 4 extra free prenatal checkups, for a total of 14.
抢救母亲，抢救低生育率，抢救低生育率。
Chanting in unison, they call for a rescue plan for Taiwan's low birth rate. This civic group says the birth rate issue is a full-blown national crisis.
All Taiwan presidents, regardless of party, have said that the birth rate issue is a national security concern.
To make it easier to have children, the cabinet has approved 10 billion NT worth of benefits. Its plan will subsidize IVF for more couples. It will also lift state subsidies for unpaid parental leave, raising it from 60 to 80% of the monthly salary. In addition, it will offer couples 14 instead of 10 free prenatal checkups and provide 2 additional days of paid leave for that purpose. All private citizens are eligible for the benefits, which have met a warm response from the public.
Of course, the more savings, the better. Maybe this will make more people want to have kids. Allowing for more OBGYN visits is also better for the babies. This is not bad at all.
But one expert says the plan doesn't do enough for fathers, who should be allowed to take days off to attend prenatal checkups with their wives.
It seems like a lot of new fathers don't really feel like a father after the baby's born, and even when they hold it in their arms. For many years, we have advocated for the government to provide equal leave for both parents for OBGYN visits. That is to say, however many days of paid leave the mother gets, the father should also get.
超疗愈的，超能想象，真的只有看到画面才感受到我要当爸爸了。
The cabinet has also eased rules to let both parents take unpaid family leave at the same time. The new rules, which are aimed at supporting families, will take effect July 1st.